Hi everyone, and welcome back to my channel, and if you're new here, welcome. My name is Lacy, and this is my art channel. It feels really good to be back. I definitely didn't mean for a whole month to go by without posting a YouTube video. If you've been watching my shorts, I did try to post a few of those, or if you're following me on other forms of social media, you may have seen me do the Inktober challenge. If you haven't seen that, I'll have all of my links in the description below. The link is called a link tree, and if you click it, you should be able to see all of my social media links. Anyway, doing Inktober and all of that was really fun, and I've been trying to increase my online presence, but sometimes it does take me a while to post on YouTube. It's not something that I really plan for, but as some of you may know, I'm also an online art teacher on a platform called Outschool, and that's my main source of income, so it does take priority over my YouTube videos, unfortunately. And also, recently, I had a medical emergency. I am fine and everything is okay now, but that did prevent me from working on my YouTube videos for a couple of weeks. I think in the future, I'm going to try to refrain from like saying when the next video is going to be up, because I really just hate not being able to post as often as I wish I could. I think that it's easy to be hard on ourselves, especially when I remember that I used to be able to upload every single week. But I'm learning to give myself grace and be proud that I am still getting YouTube videos out after over 3 years of posting them. But anyway, I thank all of you for being here and never giving me a hard time about posting. And I've always just been happy to share my art with all of you. So let's get into today's video. This is another Create This Book video. If you don't know, Create This Book was created by a YouTuber named Moriah Elizabeth. This book is an art prompt book, and it's filled with prompts, and we're going to be doing 3 of those prompts in this video. If you haven't seen my previous Create This Book videos, I'll put the playlist in the iCards above. This is Create This Book 1. There is a Create This Book 2 and 3, and I do own both of them. I wasn't sure if I should start those books now or if I should wait until I finish Create This Book 1. So if you have a preference, you can let me know in the comments below and then I can take it into consideration. So the first prompt we're going to be doing today is create a meal. It says draw/write about your ideal meal and don't forget dessert. I started out by sketching on another piece of paper. I clipped this inside my sketchbook for a few reasons. First is I have a desk mat and it's like slightly plushy, so I can't really draw on it without like ripping my paper. The second is I knew that this would bleed through the pages, so I didn't want to draw directly in the book. I also didn't want to get marker on my desk or my desk mat or anything like that. My desk mat's already collected a good amount of paint and glue and other art-related stains, so I really didn't want to add to that. I decided to draw a lasagna, as this is one of my favorite foods. I added some additional foods to help add to the spread. I added a salad and bread. I'm actually gluten-free, so I don't really eat bread like this, like baguettes, since it's hard to find them like gluten-free. But I thought it'd be cute to add something, so I went ahead and drew it, and then I drew a banana split for dessert because my favorite dessert is ice cream. After coloring it, I decided to go ahead and paint the inside of the book so I'd have a cute background for it to sit on. You might see a bit of ghosting because I actually did the other spread while I was working on this spread. I chose red and yellow because those colors are often associated with food, and then I decided to paint the background instead of doing it with marker because, again, I didn't want it to bleed through the pages. After painting it, I cut out the drawings I had drawn before and adhered them to the page. I did try to cover the pages with tape to kind of laminate it. This was to prevent them from lifting since they were just like glued on there. But I did accidentally wrinkle some of the tape. I was sad about it, but you know, mistakes give it character. Or at least that's what I tell myself. The next prompt is create simplistic drawings. Fill this page with stick figure drawings. I was happy that this was like a simple page because I spent a lot of time in that last spread. It was hard to think of what to draw at first, but then I decided to use a tip that was told to me when I was in creative writing class in university, and that was to write about what you know, or in this case, we'll draw about what we know. So I started doodling my husband and myself, and then I drew my sister, who was a power lifter, and my brother. I added a little light bulb because my brother, he's very intelligent. He likes to write, come up with new and exciting ideas. So that's just what I could think of. And he used to have like this very large beard, but I kind of regret like drawing it in this way because it kind of looks like Santa, but it's fine. You know, we live and we learn. I drew a book between my siblings because we have our own book club and they both love to read. After that, I went back and added my other little brother. I've talked about him a lot on this channel. He has Down syndrome and he loves to watch TV. With this pose, I tried to express his happiness. He's always really happy and he has like a love for life like no one else. Then I added my dog. I've drawn my dog a lot as well, and it was fun to try to figure out how to draw him but still make it somewhat look like a stick figure style. Next, I drew my mom. I added a heart because she has a big heart and she loves us all. And then I added my best friend, Hannah. She's definitely part of my family too. And I gave her a pencil because she's also an artist. Then I added my brother's dog and my sister's two dogs as well. I'm not going to talk much about the drawings on the left, mainly because there's not really any story behind it. I was trying out different expressions and activities that I thought would be cute, and I tried to draw a sheep in a stick figure style. I did think it was fairly cute, but ultimately I decided to change it. I gave that stick figure like a pumpkin head in celebration of autumn and Halloween. At the end, I remembered to add a narwhal, which is my like rule that was dictated in the beginning of the book. We had to choose a rule to include on every page. Once I did this, that reminded me that I have not done the rule in a very long time. I think at the end of the book, I'll just have to go back and add in all the narwhals. And actually, I'm doing this voiceover after I already recorded all of the footage for the video. And I think I actually forgot to add a narwhal to the other pages in the video as well. It's really hard for me to remember for some reason, but we'll go back at some point and add them all. After all of that, I used a mild liner to give a splash of color to the doodles. I still wanted to keep it fairly simplistic, but I do think that the color added a bit of liveliness to the spread. Our last prompt is create a family. Draw, attach, or assemble an image of a family. This was my hardest prompt, and it took me a while to get the motivation to do it. It took the most time out of all of the three spreads that I did. So my first inspiration came from the last spread when I was doodling my own family. I didn't really want to draw my family because I haven't practiced drawing humans that much, and I don't feel like that's really where my expertise of drawing lies. So I decided to draw my dog, my sister's dogs, and my brother's dog as like a family photo. I just thought it was a cute idea to have them posing for like a family photo. I don't know, I just thought that would be cute. I think overall it turned out fairly well. There are a few things I wish I had done differently, but overall I think it's fairly cute. I then realized I needed something to go on the adjacent page. And after some real thought, I decided to go ahead and attempt drawing a family portrait. I figured if it went really badly, I just would do something else. I used a lot of different references of me and my siblings, and this is probably the hardest thing that I have drawn in a long while, and it took a lot of patience. There was definitely a bit of panic when I started drawing, and it really wasn't coming together, and I started wondering, like, can I do this? Like, is this gonna be bad? But I kept pushing that thought away, and I just told myself something that I always tell my students all the time, and that is to trust the process. Trust that it's going to come out okay in the end. And I had to keep erasing and trying again and again, but that's okay. I told myself that it's okay to try again until you get it to look the way that you want. Drawing myself came to me somewhat naturally. I've drawn myself a lot in the past. Well, maybe not like a lot, but more than I've drawn anyone else. Drawing Miguel, my brother with Down syndrome, also was fairly hard. I was trying to convey that he has Down syndrome, and I think that was fairly difficult. And I feel like he may be the one person in the whole picture that looked the least amount like himself. Like, yes, it does look like someone who has Down syndrome, but I didn't think it necessarily looked like him. It was just difficult to express, I think. I definitely think I made the head too small, and it was hard to get the eyes right. Overall, I don't hate it, but I do think maybe next time I can do a better job. My sister Dominique was the next easiest, as we're not unlike in our facial structure. My other brother Marcus was probably the hardest. Again, I struggled to draw someone with a beard, but like not make them look too old. And after time and time again of erasing and starting over, I think in the end he looks more like himself than all of us. Overall, I was super proud that I attempted this drawing and that I was able to draw my siblings, and it looked at least somewhat like them. And I thought that this may be the best like human drawing I've ever done as of yet. I think that this will maybe motivate me to draw humans more often. So we'll see. The reason I didn't add my mom is that I'm not really good at making people look like the age that they are, if that makes sense. I thought that if I drew my mom next to us, that she was going to look the same age as us, or I was going to accidentally make her look like really old. I didn't really feel like I had the capability to draw her and make it look good. I just wanted to do her justice, so I just refrained from trying, but maybe one day I'll feel more like attempting it. We'll see. Okay, so we're finally at the end of the video. I'm gonna do a little flip through of these three pages. I hope that you enjoyed watching the video, and if you did, you can consider hitting that like and subscribe button, as that directly helps me and my channel. I think I already know what I want the next couple of videos to be, but if you have any suggestions, you can let me know in the comments below. I love to hear them, and I also really like to chat with all of you. I look forward to seeing all of you in the next one. If you made it this far, put your favorite food emoji in the comments below, so that way I know that you made it. All right, I will see you next time. Goodbye now.